With this new U11 flagship phone, HTC has shaken up and refreshed pretty much every aspect of last year's HTC 10. But can the U11 stand up tall against rivals such as the Galaxy S8 and LG's G6? Here's our full review. We're all so used to full metal HTC flagships that the glass finish of the U11 really took us by surprise. The fresh new liquid glass surface of this handset is both reflective and refractive, giving a shiny and ever-changing appearance, unless you opt for the black model like us, of course. Thankfully, you can grab it in a couple of vibrant colours too, including the sexy solar red effort, definitely your personal fave. That glossy surface does pick up smudges and greasy prints rather easily, just like the S8 and the XZ Premium before it. Make sure you wash your mitts after that late night Donner and chips before you check your Facebooks. Alarm bells may also be ringing at the very mention of glass surfacing, especially if you suffer from a chronic case of butterfingers. Thankfully, the U11 seems to be pretty hardy. After a full week of testing, the shiny rear surface remains nice and smooth. In fact, the only cosmetic damage is a tiny scratch on the screen, which is thankfully quite difficult to see. And for added reassurance, the U11 is also fully water resistant, so you can dunk it in fresh water with no ill effects. That glass backing is broken up with some slender metal edging, which is pleasingly curved at the corners. That subtle curvature makes for a comfortable grip, despite the size of this phone. Of course, one-handed use is unfortunately much easier on the Galaxy S8, thanks in large part to Samsung's awesome bezel-free finish. Like last year's HTC 10, this flagship phone sports a Quad HD Super LCD screen, which is both pleasingly sharp and wonderfully vibrant. Colours are vividly reproduced, to the same standard as most AMOLED panels out there. You also get solid contrast levels and a maximum brightness that's strong enough to counter most irritating glare. Of course, the HTC U11 doesn't boast full mobile HDR support, unlike the Galaxy S8, Sony's Xperia XZ Premium and the LG G6, so it's not quite as future-proof. Still, audio-wise, the U11 is a definite winner. You once again have HTC's stereo boom sound speakers on board, which belt out some powerful and full-bodied sound, for a phone at least. On top volume, you'll happily cut through any kind of street noise, even on a busy London road. Earphones have to be plugged directly into the U11's Type-C USB port, as there's no 3.5mm slot. Don't stress if you want to keep your old pair, however, as HTC has kindly bundled a 3.5mm jack adapter with a built-in amp to boost your tunes. How lovely. You even get a pair of HTC's used Sonic earphones shoved in the box as well. These offer really strong performance for a freebie, adapting to your personal ear shape, and even offer an active noise cancellation which draws a little bit of power from the U11. HTC's new phone also boasts 64 gigs of storage space, which can be expanded up to a further 2 TB using a microSD memory card. Handy if you shoot a lot of home video or don't have enough data to stream all of your movies and music. The HTC U11 rocks Android Nougat, with an update to Android O no doubt coming later in 2017. However, HTC has blessed Google's mobile OS with a bunch of bonus features, starting with the Edge Sense shortcut feature. This uses pressure sensors lining the left and right edges of the U11 to detect whenever you give the phone a quick squeeze. It's basically a way of quick loading your favourite apps and features, and it works very well indeed. Check out a full HTC Edge Sense Explainer video for more info. You also get HTC's shiny new Sense Companion Assistant built into the handset. Like Cortana and some other phone AI assistants, the Companion studies the way that you use your phone and then learns your habits, be they good or bad. The assistant can then offer advice when needed or simply keep things running smoothly in the background. So far, admittedly, it doesn't seem to be anything particularly revolutionary, but check back soon for a full in-depth companion review. Of course, the U11 also sports its own fingerprint sensor, now quite a common feature on modern mobiles. This is built into the narrow home button, positioned just beneath the screen, and despite its slender size, that sensor is impressively accurate. Even with moist fingers, we rarely had any trouble unlocking the device. You can expect a speedy reaction too, with the handset's desktops popping up in well under a second. When it comes to performance, the HTC U11 is again one of the best around right now. That's thanks to the extremely powerful Snapdragon 835 chipset, which offers a significant bump in power over older chips. You get improved VR support, boosted security features, and plenty more built in. For any curious geeks out there, the U11 scored an average AnTuTu score of 176,000. No surprise then that the everyday run is as smooth as oily butter. The latest games such as Injustice 2 play with a perfect frame rate throughout. Battery life is also commendable, helped along by that Snapdragon 835 chipset. Even with heavy use, we usually made it through a full day with the U11 and past lunchtime the following day before a charge was ever needed. You do, of course, get the usual battery saver modes on board as well, in case you do need a bit of extra life before finally hitting the plug. One of the most intriguing features of the U11 is, of course, that all-new UltraPixel 3 camera that HTC has slapped on the rear. This 12 megapixel snapper boasts an f1.7 aperture lens, which promises great low light performance comparable to the Galaxy S8. In fact, the U11 actually outperformed Samsung's flagship camera in some of our tests. Check out our in-depth U11 camera review for all you need to know. The HTC U11 is exactly the kind of flagship phone that the company needed to launch in 2017. It's once again a highly enjoyable all-round experience, but also feels fresh enough to stand out against earlier handsets as well as rival premium mobiles. Sure, some of the competition offers HDR-ready displays and super slim bezel-free design work, which arguably trumps the funky edge sense and companion features. However, the U11 is still a media beast, while that camera is definitely one of the best around right now. For a full HTC U11 review and all you need to know about HTC's latest flagship phone, check out recombi.com/mobile, and don't forget to subscribe to the Recombi YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.